Hi everybody, welcome to White Paper on Whiteboard. My name is Miguel Vita. I work for Freudenberg on the Hydraulic Accumulators Division, and I was invited today by our partners ESP International to talk about hydraulic accumulators. And we decided to start with the basics. What is an accumulator? How can I use an accumulator? And what are the different technologies that we have on an accumulator? So let's start with what is an accumulator. Well, think in an air balloon inserted in a bucket and just apply a force in this balloon. So you increase the pressure on the air side of the balloon. This is the basic principle of an accumulator. You have an accumulator with a hard shell, normally carbon steel, very similar to the bucket that I showed you before. And you have an elastomeric diaphragm. And this elastomeric diaphragm will make a barrier to a pre-charged nitrogen session. You can compare the pre-charged nitrogen with the air that you have in your balloon. This port is connected to the hydraulic system. So the hydraulic system will apply pressure in this portion and will be translated on the same action that you have with this force. So basically, when you have the hydraulic system, you increase the pressure in the nitrogen area. What happens on the hydraulic system? And we have here a schematic of a hydraulic. So you have a hydraulic cylinder, valve, pumps, a tank, and we have added an accumulator in the system. When the hydraulic system has no pressure, you have the pre-charge of the nitrogen here using the whole cavity of the accumulator. On the other side, when you have a force being applied on your cylinder, for example, you have a shovel in your tractor and the shovel hits a stone, you have a huge force being applied here that will increase the pressure in the whole system. This oil, this pressurized oil, will be moving to the accumulator and will increase the nitrogen pressure. So this nitrogen inside the accumulator will work as a cushion. You have dampening the system using the accumulator. This comes to the basic functions of the accumulator, starting with the pulsation dampening. On the hydraulic system, you have pulsation. This pulsation is coming basically from the hydraulic pumps. So the accumulator will make a dampening on this pulsation and will stabilize your system. So you reduce the noise, you reduce the vibration of the system, and you have the system working smooth. Also, the accumulator can keep the constant pressure in your system. If you have a leakage, for example, you're going to lose the pressure of the system. The accumulator will stabilize the pressure and you'll keep the pressure in a certain level until you can stop your system for maintenance. Another function for the accumulator is really to be an emergency source of power in your system. For example, when you have your system being applied on hydraulic brakes and you need a sudden release of pressure in your system, the accumulator will help you releasing this pressure whenever it is needed. And here we come to the three different types of accumulator. We have the bladder, diaphragm, and the piston type accumulators. Bladder is the bread and butter. You can use bladder accumulators everywhere. Most of the hydraulic systems use bladder accumulators. Basically, you have a bladder bag. You have the pre-charge of nitrogen connected to the hydraulic system. Those accumulators are used in pulsation dampening, where you have high frequency, especially, and small amplitude. A lot of applications, right? But this type of accumulator has a restriction. The bladder has a vulcanization seam, and this is the weak point of the bladder system. if you have a high frequency in a high cycle demand, you can have a rupture in this seam. And this is the restriction of this type of accumulator. Then we can go to the diaphragm type accumulator. Basically the same, where you have a carbon steel shell, but instead of a bladder, you have a diaphragm. Also, precharger of nitrogen, and this portion is connected to the system. Very similar application on the bladder type accumulator with an advantage. Since you don't have a seam in the diaphragm, you don't have the restrictions that you have on the bladder type accumulator. So application is pretty much the same, but this one is really a reliable accumulator, especially when you have high cycle demands, where you have applications with 1 million, 2 million, 3 million cycle demands. This is where to use a diaphragm accumulator. And then we go to the piston type accumulator. Instead of a bladder or a diaphragm, we are using an aluminum piston to make the barrier with the nitrogen. You keep with the nitrogen precharge. The system is connected to your hydraulic system. But really, you don't have limits of this type of accumulator. Since it's a machined accumulator, you can make it in any size. You can make accumulators with 1/4 gallon. You can make accumulators with 300 gallons. You can make accumulators going to 40,000 PSI. Custom ports, custom design and materials. So the piston accumulator is really for limited applications where you can make custom design accumulators. Thank you.